I am the partner of the sun, for he bows his head each night so I may breathe. I am the resplendent sterling silver orb, accompanying the earth in unwavering loyalty. I come out at night to guide your steps. I listen to the lonely who share their secrets with me. I am the object of fascination, the cause of many a sleepless night of serenading poetry in my praises. I play hide and seek with you, sometimes hiding behind a cloud-like veil, sometimes reigning like the matriarch of the skies. I master the oceans, making them rough then tranquil. My sirens call to them just as apparent in mankind. Maybe that is why, when people fall in love, they sometimes call that person after me. Even I have admired such beauty. The most beautiful person I ever gazed upon was a man called Abbas, the one who introduced himself on the battlefield as the Moon of the House of Hashim. At first, a hint of jealousy arose in me to see him fairer than myself. But I kept looking and found my jealousy was in vain. For never was there a kinder brother, a devoted protector, and chivalrous victor than Abbas. If I had been there at the river, I would have begged him to drink. No one would have blamed you, O Abbas. But he threw the water back, preferring the children of Hussein over himself. They shot an arrow towards the moon. How careless they were! What did they think they could achieve? With no arms, but still holding the skin of the flask by his teeth. He fell to the ground, and the eclipse was complete. Once a silvery moon, now stained by blood. I wept and wept to see Zainab weeping every night, because every time she looked at me, she would cry out, "You are nothing compared to Abbas." In every corner of the earth, one moon reigns supreme, but in Karbala, there are two. Alas, how I wish I could abdicate and surrender myself before the worthier moon, buried under its dust.